It's like little intuition. There you go. Now, I can tell you from personal experience of having been a very wounded masculine that when the feminine listens to her intuition, her actual intuition, not her ego's voice, when she trusts her intuition, she's never fucking wrong. Never. And it is, I can't, this is another thing I can't explain. I've been in a situation once where I was actually, and this is, I'm being very honest about it. In my past, when I was very wounded, I was actually cheating on my partner. And she at the time, not just knew something wrong was wrong, she just knew I wasn't in the place I was supposed to be. So she's like, where are you? And I was like, oh, this is blah, blah. She's like, are you sure? And blah, blah, whatever. I was like, yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I was trying to overcompensate and be like, trust me, trust me, trust me. What was that? Remember the verbal shit? I was like, trust me, trust me, trust me. Trying to make her feel like, oh yeah, you know, you should need to believe where I'm at, blah, blah, blah. And even after that episode, it's not that she didn't trust me anymore, but after that episode, she kept coming back. She's like, I don't know why, like that day just bugs me. I'm like, can you just let it go already? Like, there's nothing, you know? But her intuition is fucking spot on. And that's why I learned also, as a healthy masculine, I need the feminine voice. Not only my own feminine, but when I get into a relationship, I need to get with someone who trusts my intuition, because she will lead me to helping me create something powerful and to build a kingdom. That's how complementary these energies are. It's fucking amazing. So, another one here is spiritual energy. This is very, very, very feminine. Now, spiritual energy doesn't... Spiritual feminine? No, what's that name? Spiritual energy. Spiritual energy doesn't have to mean that you go to fucking every temple in the world and you do all that shit. But it also is part of trusting your intuition. It also is a part of trusting the messaging you receive. Now, as you start doing this work with us, Christina's going to take you through some chakra work. But tomorrow I'll probably talk about it more, about how some of the chakras within us actually help us tune in. When you're really connected to your body and you're reaching a state of like attunement, you can use the upper chakras to connect to the wisdom of the universe, which means a lot of your intuition, which means a lot. Is the fan too fast?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Which means you're connecting to a lot of like the wisdom through your spiritual energy that comes to you. Now, that's why actually in, I think, like I said, over the period of time, religious leaders have tended to be women, but I study a lot of anthropology, and in my opinion, earlier, women were really, really, really powerful, like spiritual mediums, which even now you can see like tarot card readers, this, that, whatever. The problem is a lot of wounded masculine men who were not being in the limelight, who were not getting extra validation, started to feel insecure. This is also another one that's a healthy masculine will not be insecure. It will be confident, as we talked about confidence down here. But those men started to feel really insecure. These women, who are so spiritual and interpreting all of this fucking amazing information from like, whether it's the gods, the universe, the stars, whatever, they are being recognized and validated more than us. They're the ones who are gonna be like, they were actually becoming roses, but those thorns were fucking jealous. They wanted to be the roses. So what they did was they brandished the women who had the spiritual power as being witches, as being heretics. And so they burnt them at the stake. And those religious leaders got together to say women should be banished from religious like powers and leadership, because they were afraid that if they became powerful, they'd be too powerful. Now, in my opinion, I realized since we talk about leadership being a healthy masculine trait, I do believe that the masculine needs to be at the top of leadership, but I believe it needs to have also an equal supporting unit of spiritual energy by its side, hence king and queen, you know? The king may be the leader, the ruler. Have you heard that statement that behind every successful man is like a really powerful woman? I never knew what it meant or believed it until like in the recent past. And I'm like, holy fucking shit. I do saw that. Another thing, and if y'all are okay with it, I will use a lot of my relationship as an example, because this is something I've recently stepped into discovering for myself, and I've seen the fucking power. I go to Aisha so often to check in on a lot of even business decisions, which earlier used to separate completely, to say, what do you think about this? What is the feeling that you're getting about this? And like last night at dinner, we talked, mm-hmm. she'll maybe go to some of her like spiritual leaders and say, what do you think this is about? And this is a girl who has no fucking business idea about like any structure or anything. And yet the answers she'll give me will be something about what is the energy with certain things. I don't know if I trust it, I don't know. One huge thing in our relationship that we've had to step into, which has propelled us forward, is trust. The woman, the feminine is so trusting. Now, that's the problem, is sometimes when you get into the wounded feminine, you can be too trusting, right? You get into the space of being like, oh, I'll just allow everything. That's actually not truly trusting. We just brandish it as being trusting. That's also victimization. You're allowing something to happen. You can sense. Whenever I've worked with people, clients of like grooms, individuals, and they say, oh, I never saw the red flags. He was an asshole. Not never saw the red flags. He was like, he just became an asshole and cheated me at this point. I was like, no, if you look at the relationship, I can help you spot at least 12 red flags before you even knew they were there. And when you go back, they're like, wow, yeah, that's true. I saw this before. Jerrica brought up a really good example yesterday where she said like she was with this guy and talk about the relationship, and then later when I asked her, what do you think about it? She was like, no, actually, it wasn't what was good for me. And the woman needs to trust herself. This, can you see how these two are very similar? Intuition and trusting herself. So if she does not trust herself, the woman abandons herself. And that is very dangerous. Because when a woman abandons herself, she becomes and gets into victimization, where she's like, nothing's working out, everyone's abusive, men are assholes, and men, wounded men will say women are gold diggers. Why? Because they're afraid of providing. So you can see how like the balance just doesn't exist at that point anyway. And then comes dysfunction.